Turns out we're part of the biggest event during the summer games. The beer run. The Bud World Party continues. Round the clock, around the world.
Recently, Car and Driver magazine rated Dodge Intrepid over the new Ford Taurus. They described Intrepid as poised, agile, and athletic. They said it was born to run. They went on about its vast interior, calling Intrepid outstanding, and concluded, it's a lot of car for the money. Car and Driver just can't say enough about Intrepid, but we like it when they try. Intrepid, this changes everything.
And a chance run. Stockton Bailey. What a pass. You gotta love it, baby. Short. For three to tie it. He dies. Unbelievable.
Every play going the Magic's way. He'll challenge.
The lob.
Here is tonight's Dutch boy in the paint. And because of the foul trouble of Kemp, Karl Malone has had the big edge in this game, outscoring him 24-7. But look how many more times the Jazz have gotten to the free throw line tonight from game one.
It's a definite, a major plus for the Jazz. During the course of the year, they got there 29 times. Now, this is the guy right now that the Sonics are betting, the coaching staff is saying, he's going to play 10 minutes and 44 seconds, that the referees are not going to call a sixth foul on him. He's going to stay in the game and lead us back. And you're smiling. Okay?
All right. It's a lot of time.
Well, you know, Sean Kemp has only played 17 minutes in this game.
Nate McMillan had an offensive foul.
Well, it's a moving screen. Moving screen by Frank Murkowski.
Four foul on Murkowski, and so the Jazz, who had their 8-point lead cut in hand, now with the ball, with 2.5 minutes remaining. So Murkowski has picked up four fouls in 4 minutes. He picked up three fouls in 15 minutes in game number one. Murkowski with the four against Karl Malone, who dribbles it off his foot. Loose ball, and Benoit alertly in midcourt. 3 seconds on the clock, and the double team works. Kemp goes in. Sean Kemp down with 9 points. And I tell you, the Sonics are so quick to track and cause that turnover anywhere on the floor.
Dick, he jumped over the top of Antoine Kemp.
Rayman personified. Malone double team. Nearly a steal by Kemp, and the jumper by Benoit. 75-71, the Jazz lead here in the fourth quarter as the Utah Jazz 1-5 on the road in the playoffs, trying to even the series at 1-1.
Now, just keep an eye on this as this ball is kicked out. A little scrum going on here. A nice strip by Gary Payton. Now, just watch this elevation right here. Up, over.
Big dog. Carr, meanwhile, with his third personal foul. Kemp double team. Askew. Foul from behind.
See, I like what Askew did that time, Dick. He's not really a big three-point shooter. When that ball was diagonal passed out to him, he gave the head fake, took it off the dribble, and forced the defenders to foul him as they were running to him.
He hasn't been a good free throw shooter, so that's not a bad move as he misses the first. That was a Hornacek's foul, only his first of the game. And the Sonics come in with their leading scorer, Sam Perkins, who had, in game number one, 13 off the bench, 15 tonight. Murkowski going to the bench with four fouls.
See, during Askew's career, he's a 75% foul shooter, but in the playoffs this year, for whatever reason, he's only shooting 56%.
75-72, Utah's lead is three. Seattle's only loss in the playoffs this season have come right here at Key Arena against the Sacramento Kings, and it was in game two, and you pointed out, the last 3 years, Seattle has ran a foul in game twos of their various series. They've won game ones in every one of them. will go to the line.
First of all, Jeff Hornacek forced a long shot. And then, miraculously, Utah kept that one alive on the offensive glass.
Malone, 10 for 13 at the free throw line. Want to remind you, tomorrow evening, game two, without Horace Grant, the Magic will have to go back to the United Center, go against the Bulls, and we'll be with you on Friday night from the Delta Center in Salt Lake City for game three of the series between the Sonics and the Jazz. Malone, one free throw. He's got 25 points and a four-point Utah lead. McMillan down low, double team quickly on Kemp. He'll go back to him. Baseline spin. Fake by Pink. He missed the three, and McMillan tips it away. Great play by Nate McMillan to keep it alive.
Great hustle.
And Payton quickly fires up a three. Gary Payton with his second from downtown has 14.
Well, that's what they do so well. In the playoffs, Payton is averaging 5 3 attempts a game, and he's shooting 44%.
Stockton trying to get it to Hornacek. A tough pass for Stockton to make. That was a bad pass by Stockton, and a foul committed at the other end.
Yeah, they cut him off, and they go for the steal, but they get caught. That time, as Benoit caught up to him, he definitely caused contact. Now, Gary Payton was stunned a little bit here. Now, see, right there, Stockton tries to pinpoint it. Vinny Askew from the top, and at this end, watch Benoit. He fouled him right there.
Stockton with his third foul, and so on one hand, he got Payton with four steals and Stockton with six turnovers, and Hersey Hawkins comes back in the game. Hawkins with four personal fouls as Payton goes out of the game. Shaken up.
Well, you can see, Dick, just in a little scrimmage there, he not only hits a three, he makes two steals. He ignites them in the last minute and a half.
He's had a brilliant playoff. And Sean Kemp fouled before the shot.
Hey, Antoine Carr, you can't complain when you have your arm wrapped around the guy like for a little slow dancing. I mean it's got to be a foul.
That's four on Antoine Carr. So Payton over on the sidelines being worked on by Frank Furtado. This will be a two-shot foul. Kemp 5 of 6 from the line, 9 points in the game, and he got the crowd out of its feet with this monster dunk earlier. A little extra over Antoine Carr on that one. And the Sonics regain the lead by one. It's 5 minutes gone by in the fourth quarter.
Right now, you know Antoine Carr is an excellent score. Oh, Carr left that one short.
Benoit had a chance. And Carl Malone short. So the Sonics quickly back, leading by one.
I'm surprised that the Jazz are not looking to go to Antoine Carr. Down inside on Sean Kemp with 5 fouls. He's been out here now 5 minutes.
McMillan throws it away into the hands of Malone. So Nate McMillan with an errant pass inside. Stockton pulls up for three. Long rebound to McMillan.
Stockton loves that shot. Remember, Malone, Hornacek, and Stockton through the season all shot over 40% in threes.
Kemp, double team, McMillan. And Benoit with the rebound for the Jazz. Trailing by one, nearly halfway through this fourth quarter of game number two. Jazz being trounced by 30 in game one.
You can see they track Stockton. Once he makes the pass, they match up. We're already at 7 seconds.
Stockton driving against Perkins. And there's Benoit from the corner. Malone fighting for the offensive rebound. Rejected by Sean Kemp. And goaltending called against Kemp. And give Malone the basket. He now has 27 points.
Big thing now, Dick. You're the defensive coach. You had the goaltending call. That's okay. Keep going for it.
Better than the sixth foul.
That's absolutely. Once you get down inside, anything can happen here. Now, this is close. Carl gets it up here right now. Now, to me, I think that ball was on its way up. That's my opinion. Okay? It was close.
Timeout called by the Sonics.
Come on! Game starts in 20 minutes!
Grand, here we go!
Not a fanatic. Look your best in NBA Authentics apparel from Lee Sport, officially licensed by the NBA, NFL, NHL, and Major League Baseball. Lee Sport, the brand for fans like you. STP Son of a Gun Protectant makes vinyl truly shine. Leather, more lustrous. And rubber, more brilliant and beautiful. It works so well, in fact, some people even use it on cars. Son of a Gun Protectant, and also Son of a Gun Citrus Cleaner by STP.
Picture this, a romantic comedy written directed by me, starring you and Tyra Banks, be a smash.
Yeah, that's fine, Spike. Listen, Spike, no disrespect, but I'm trying to watch my main man, Pennant, dismantle the Nick.
What's up, Spike?
What's up? Hey, Pennant, pass it to Nick. No, not Nick, Horace. Pennant, pass it to Horace. He's open. Oh, on the baseline. On the baseline, What? Five seconds.
Thanks a lot.
Hey, just trying to help him, man. Now, Spike, about that film. Is this an action flick? Because I do my own stunt.
Hey, y'all, we're Brooks.
And Dunn, and we want you to know you're NASCAR on TBS.
Utah Jazz trying to steal one on the road in game two. Let's go back and review the contest. In the first quarter, John Stockton, not 100% in ailing, came up with 9 points as the Jazz led by five. But the second quarter, it was the Seattle bench to spark them. And the half was all tied at 42. And in the third quarter, the mailman, Karl Malone, came up with 18 points and an 8-point lead by Utah after three. But it's a 1-point game and an exciting game two here in Seattle. Maybe the game has no rhyme or reason, and that may be great for the fans in the final 5:44.
Well, the main thing is it's exciting.
Yes, it is.
Now, the offensive rebounding, the Sonics only have two for the game. In game one, they had 11 for 12 points. Karl Malone is out-rebounding them on the offensive glass by himself, 7-2.
You know he was going to come out fired up tonight. Dedlick Schrempf with a turnaround, fouled, and he drew that foul. Dedlick Schrempf, very dangerous in the fourth quarter. Benoit with his second personal foul. Schrempf, relatively quiet tonight, has scored 10 points, averaging over 17 in the playoffs. Going in the line for the second time.
Well, you know, he's such a high-profile guy for them in their offense on the post-ups. And you have a tendency sometimes in transition to forget about him because he's an outstanding three-point shooter. But they will go to him on the post.
Sean Kemp has played many minutes here in the fourth quarter with five personal fouls, and he has avoided the sixth. We have had 15 lead changes in this game, and the Sonics are up by one. Stockton guarded by Payton. And Hawkins smothering Hornacek. Carr on the pick and roll. Hornacek. In and out. Rebound, Schrempf.
The defense hesitated. That opened up that shot by Jeff.
And a discontinued call against Gary Payton.
Well, you know, I'm glad that Stockton made that call tonight rather than you, because in the last game, you were making a lot of calls. Right, but Stockton called that one, and it was.
They just weren't looking over.
You had it all the way.
29 turnovers in the game.
Now they bring him alone on the baseline again. The back screen set by Hornacek. Here's the double team.
And here is Antoine Carr driving the lane. And getting a piece of it was Sean Kemp. Good defense by Kemp as he gets a piece of it. His second block. 1-point lead for the Sonics. Here is Schrempf going in and a foul called against Utah. The Jazz already in the penalty. with 4:36 remaining in the fourth quarter.
Well, Pedlick, yeah, he's an excellent dribbler. When he was at Indiana, you know, he won the sixth man award for 2 years. Here he's now also, any time that you can take it from coast to coast off the middle and handle the ball on the fast break, he's dangerous when he's dribbling.
Pedlick Trapp with 14 points tonight. Foul was on Hornacek, his second.
During the course of the year, Dedlick, a 78% foul shooter. At the other end, Antoine Carr ended up with a very, very poor shot for a strong drive like he had in the lane.
80-78, the Sonics lead with 4:35 remaining in the fourth quarter.
All the screens for Carr on the line. This quarter, he's been catching the basketball outside the lane. If you remember, he had his big quarter, the third, when he was catching it in the paint.
Of the key tipped in by Carr. Big tip in to tie the game at 80 by Antoine Carr.
Anytime that you trap and they get the ball below the trap, it's a 4-on-3.
Jazz coming off their worst loss of the season and their biggest defeat in playoff history. Illegal defense against the Jazz, and that is the second technical called against Utah. And Percy Hawkins will go to the line to try to untie this game.
Well, Jerry Sloan's upset. The call was on Jeff Hornacek, who was on the other side of the floor.
Hawkins 3-for-3 from the line tonight. Remains perfect, one of the better free throw shooters, as is Hornacek on the Jazz. Setting a screen. Coming around, the pink goes in and lays it in.
That was just beautiful. Kept his dribble, Grant Stockton back and forth off the screen, and when the screen man, the defensive man, didn't help him, just took it to the rim.
16 points, 8 assists, 4 steals for Gary Payton, who continues to play sensational ball in the playoffs. Missed by Malone, and Kemp gets the rebound with 3.5 to play, and a 3-point Seattle advantage.
George Karl is looking good because Sean Kemp is playing big since 10 minutes and 44 seconds when he came into this game with 5 fouls.
And Payton is fouled by John Stockton, and that'll be number 5 on Stockton.
Now just keep an eye on Payton as he rubs Stockton, and as he turns the corner right here, Benoit was late. Payton will take it every time right to the front of the rim.
That's 4 fouls, not 5 on John Stockton, but Payton misses the front end of the free throw.
That's kind of interesting. During the course of the year, he was a 75% shooter. But all of a sudden now in the playoffs, he's only shooting 61.
Timeout, the Sonics by 4. 3:18 to go. Crunch time coming up.
Put Dodge Intrepid's windshield in the usual place. We moved it forward and down to enhance visibility and aerodynamics. The wheels were moved toward the corners to make it more stable. And now many features that were options are standard. So even though Intrepid has air, speed control, power windows, and more, the price isn't where you'd expect to find it either. It's lower. Dodge Intrepid. This changes everything. Sometimes war is hell. Sometimes it is not. Watch 3 days and nights of the mightiest war movies ever made, where you'll see war at its worst and men at their best.
Before I'm through with you, you're gonna move like one man and think like one man.
Dig in for this year's Memorial Day weekend edition of Operation TNT, beginning Saturday at 1 with Objective Burma.
They've carried your bologna sandwiches, PB&J's on white, and Mom's special tuna salad. Punch, Starsky, Hutch and the Angels. Only the coolest shows made it to the metal screen. You carried them then, we carry them now. TNT's Lunchbox TV. You can still see your lunch pail friends, weekdays on TNT.
Knicks lead the Jazz 84-80, 3:18 remaining after an 8-point lead after three. And there's Malone, and a far cry from the 18-point third quarter, isn't it, for him?
Well, you can see the catches are there, Dick, and you can see what he's done in the paint. The jumpers, he's way off his game. He's been fouled. He's 11 for 15. But in the third quarter, when they made their move, he had 18 points. In this quarter, only three. The big reason, all of the screens that they're setting, Seattle is doing a good job forcing him out of the painted area on the catch.
Jazz are only 3 for 15 shooting here in this fourth quarter. Again, they go to Malone, guarded by Perkins. Malone gets the basket and draws the foul. So that time, against the defense of Perkins, Malone gets the tough hoop, 29 points, and Perkins picks up his second.
Now that was all muscle. Just keep an eye on this now as they drop it down inside. Perkins is bumping. He has his forearm on him. As he comes in here, he loses his balance as he's bumped. Catches it. All upper body strength.
On the line for the 16th time tonight. 10 more times than he experienced in game one.
And I know you got to make them. You have to make them. The opportunity's there for you. You're getting a good whistle. You're getting to the line.
And the lead is one for the Sonics. And Hawkins have been gone at it defensively. Stockton and I like Ray Payton in the low post. And Payton gets tripped with six on the shot clock, and he'll go to the line to shoot two.
No doubt about any time that you put Payton down in there. Now they have to run someone out. They cannot allow Payton to shoot over the top of Stockton.
Carr with his fifth personal foul. Sonics getting ready to bring in Nate McMillan. Stopper into the game. Payton 1 for 3 now from the free throw line. Hawkins leaves the game, replaced by McMillan. Hawkins tonight has scored 6 points.
As we go down to the finish, Utah has 3 timeouts and a 20. Seattle, 3 timeouts.
85-83, Seattle leading. George Karl's team, 64 game winner during the regular year, looking to take a 2-0 lead at home, and the Jazz trying to win one on the road and go home for two with the series all even. Here's Benoit, double team, and Hornacek in the lane. No-look pass to Karl Malone, who hits. Big basket for Malone, and the Jazz have tied it up at 85. 32, Malone matches the number on his uniform.
Dick, you hit it right on the head. The no-look. They ran right to Stockton at the top and opened up Malone.
Winding down to 2 minutes remaining in the fourth quarter, 9 on the shot clock. And now 2 minutes to go. Kemp has avoided that 6th foul in the fourth quarter. Payton with a spectacular runner, but it falls off into the hands of Carr.
Stockton got a little piece of that shot as he brought it up.
And the crowd on its feet defensively for the Sonics. Tie game, 1:40 remaining.
Same play over and over. The last 3 times down the floor.
Now they double. Shrimp came over the double team. 2 on the shot clock. Hornacek fires it up. And he was off balance. He had to rush that shot.
He sure did. That Utah got caught with bad spacing. One defender played 2 guys on the other side of the lane.
Now the Sonics looking to break the tie. They have 12 on the shot clock. Kemp working against Malone. 13 points, but more important, staying in the game and not fouling out, gives the Sonics the lead again.
Now, George Karl is looking very good right now, because Sean has had an excellent fourth quarter.
1 minute remaining, 12 on the shot clock, and inside, Carr gets the basket. Very tough hoop for Antoine.
That was a terrific move, because if he came in front, it was going to be blocked.
87-87 and 15 on the shot clock. This game going down to the wire here at the Key Arena. Again, they go to Kemp. Kemp going strong to the hoop and scores again. Kemp with 2 big baskets against Karl Malone. And it's 89-87 in favor of the Sonics. John Stockton doubled again. Throws the ball away into Sean Kemp's hands.
Great play.
Great anticipation by Kemp, and a costly turnover by Stockton.
What they're saying right now,
is, you know, you're looking at this, you're down 2 points. You're saying here now that you're just going to let the clock run down. It's going to be about a 3-4 second difference.
3 seconds on the shot clock, and Douglas Shrimp misses as the buzzer goes off. And let's see what the ruling is. And they say that the shot was taken in time and last touch by Utah, and Seattle can run out the clock.
See, when you gamble like that, when you gamble and the clock runs down and they shoot, if they get the ball back, well, then naturally the game is going to be over. You're kind of surprised that they didn't foul, stop the clock, make them make the foul shots, okay? And then that way you're controlling the end of the game. As it is right now, they have the basketball.
They're on the brink of going up 2-0.
Nice pants.
Dockers, flat front khakis.
We're hot and wow. Call Domino's now.
There is only one pizza that makes my picky taste buds go ooh, ooh, ooh. It's Domino's pizza, just the way Domino's does it. That crust with that pepperoni, those zesty herbs. I like the deep dish crust, the hand-tossed crust, any Domino's crust. Just crust, crust, crust. Got to try your favorite toppings and tons of cheese on that Domino's crust. It's your turn. For hot and wild, call Domino's now. And in a few minutes, you'll know what I mean.
Gravity.
By Foot Locker.
Of all the laws of nature, you are my least favorite.
It's not your fault you exist, but gravity.
You are no friend of mine.
You do not belong in my house.
My house.
Though you show up every morning.
I defy you, gravity. You are not my obstacle.
That grin you see, that's me knowing I will beat you.
If only for an instant.
Even if it's just for an instant.
Foot Locker, where it all begins and gravity ends.
Sean Kemp with two big baskets and a big steal in the last minute and 11. And the Sonics on the brink of another victory.
Now, this is just a great move by Sean. He takes it right into the heart of the defense. Makes the play at the other end of the floor. A long diagonal pass. Watch Kent shoot the gap. Now, once they came up over half court, I was just stunned that they didn't foul. They allow the clock to go down. It just catches the rim, but the ball goes out of bounds off Hornacek.
Percy Hawkins in the game. And Perkins will inbound with 2.4 seconds, and there is the foul that will send Detlef Schrempf to the line. Maybe a case too little too late in that sense. So Sean Kemp, who came in with about a minute and a half gone by in the fourth quarter, and the Sonics down by six. Seattle outscored Utah 22-14. Kemp scored 8 points, made a big steal. And George Karl looks like the hero after all.
Well, he gambled and he won. And that's why we said at that time, you know your player and you're betting that a star player is not going to pick up a cheap sixth foul to exit him from the ballgame.
Coming up next on Inside the NBA, Tim Hardaway joins Vince Cellini from our Atlanta studios.
Now, for all of the guys who would have fouled, you went to clock management. For all of you who did not want to foul, you're playing that they have 4 points some odd seconds if the shot clock would have run off or if they would have shot and missed.
So now it is a 4 point deficit and 1.6 seconds to go.
Well, now you're looking for the impossible, the 3 point shot where you get fouled.
The quest begins this August.
Once upon a time, three girls went to Rocksteady for a pickup game.
No! We got next.
Lisa is the center U.S. women's basketball team. Cheryl's a forward. Dawn's a point guard.
Shoot that, Cheryl. Take the jump, Lisa. We'll take
it again.
Okay,
again.
Get next. Get shot.
That's the next one.
I got you.
He can't shoot either.
And this isn't a fairy tale, so they didn't beat every guy. But they beat enough to say, basketball is basketball, athletes are athletes.
Announcing Goodyear's Race Days Tire Sale. Save up to 25% on all Goodyear Eagles and all Goodyear Wranglers. Other Goodyear tires from 1999. Get to Goodyear and save. And ask about Infinitread with a lifetime Tread Life limited warranty.
To make this beauty look its best, I use Armor All Protectant on the vinyl and rubber. And for the paint. Now there's Armor Plate Paint Protectant. It shines, protects, and really makes those colors pop. New Armor Plate. It's like Armor All for your paint.
Looking for something?
Yeah, that dime from Sprint's long distance plan.
Having trouble finding it, huh?
Yeah.
Well, that's because depending on when you call, the Sprint Sense rate isn't always a dime. It could be a quarter or 65 cents on calls to Canada.
Oh.
Try AT&T True Reach Savings. On average, most people can save more than with Sprint Sense when they spend $25 a month on calls in the U.S. Plus, you'll always save more on calls to Canada.
Wow, I found what I'm looking for.
That's your true choice, AT&T.
'91-'87, 1.6 to go, and the last words Hubie said before we went to the break was, you need a miracle.
Now, right there, you see, Peyton had the ball, Kemp had the ball, they didn't foul, the shot clock is going down, you're relying that you're going to get the ball with about 4 seconds to go, but they catch the rim, and as the ball goes out of bounds, now as you throw it in, now you know yourself right now, the biggest thing is no one foul anyone. Just let them shoot the shot.
And the buzzer, no basket, if it's gone, the game is over. And the Utah Jazz, who carried an 8-point lead into the fourth quarter, and George Karl, who brought in Sean Kemp in the opening moments with 5 personal fouls. Kemp never fade foul out. Got 2 big baskets and a critical steal.